Hello everyone, today's topic is behavioral modeling in Verilog. I have already discussed about the two lower level modeling. One is gate level modeling and another one is data flow modeling. So in gate level modeling, what we do, we use the primitives that is already defined inside the Verilog library. So these primitives we instantiate and we design our logic. So here we are utilizing the predefined modules or predefined, what is the primitives or predefined logic gates that is included inside the Verilog library, and we design our logic. So bringing means using a primitives is nothing but directly utilizing a piece of hardware. Like if I write like this and YAB, then I am directly using a piece of hardware and which infers a hardware AND gate. Okay. So this is gate level modeling. So here I know how my input data will flow from input to output. Here I have the idea. The designer has idea that how the input data, how the information is flowing from input to output. Because the designer knows very well that this is a AND gate or this is a OR gate or this is a NAND gate. So the designer is aware of the flows of data from input to output or what he is doing or what she is doing. Okay, so instantiating primitive is like that. And in data flow modeling, what we saw is we are using Boolean expression, like for AND gate this one, then for OR gate, XOR gate. So directly we are here also directly the designer knows how the data, how the signals are flowing from inside, from input to output. So if I write Y, A and B, that means I'm directly using, means I'm instantiating a piece of hardware, means I'm, so this code will be interpreted as a AND gate, which is two input and one output. If I write like that A or B, then it will be interpreted by the synthesis tool as this is a XOR, this is a OR gate. This is a OR gate. So here the designer, the logic designer aware of the things that how the inputs are flowing from input to output, both in gate level modeling and data flow modeling. Because in gate level modeling, the designer has idea that what he is doing or what the logic that he is writing, what it infers, means how the tools will interpret the respective logic. And in data flow modeling also, the designer knows very well the how the signal will be flowing from input to output, because he is implementing Boolean expression and these things are interpreted as the real hardware. Okay. But behavioral modeling, this is a highest level of modeling in Verilog. This modeling technique doesn't give any kind of information how it will be implemented into actual hardware. So if I synthesis a code which is written using the behavioral modeling technique, then the synthesis tool may not be able to interpret that particular behavioral modeling code into a real hardware. Okay. And it just defines the behavior of digital component. As it is a behavioral modeling, so it is just defines the behavior of digital component, but it doesn't always implement the actual hardware. So the ultimate goal is whenever we write a code, the ultimate goal is that that synthesis tool should be able to interpret the piece of logic into the hardware. Okay, but during this behavioral modeling technique, there is no guarantee that code will be synthesized. Okay, this one we have to remember, that behavioral modeling, the behavioral code may not be synthesizable. Okay, and it doesn't give information how registers and gate will be implemented to perform required operation. For example, during this gate level modeling and data flow modeling, we had the idea that how we are playing with the gates, different type of gates. And already, for example, in primitives when you are using, we know very well that we are using AND gate or we are using OR gate. And in data flow modeling also, we know that we are using some Boolean expression. This is AND, this is OR, this is XOR. So directly we are playing with the real hardware. But in behavioral modeling, we have no idea about the hardware that we are using. So it will be interpreted by the synthesis tool as per what it understands. Okay. So it is more like writing an algorithm in C language. The behavioral modeling is more like writing an algorithm in C language. We are just implementing the behavior of our circuit or logic and not the real hardware. And what is the algorithm means? Algorithm is a piece of this mathematical representation of task. It can be implemented in software using a computer or a DSP processor or in hardware as ASIC, application specific integrated circuit. Okay. As I already said that this behavioral modeling, it describes the behavior at higher level, and it is not intended to be synthesizable. The code may be synthesizable, may not be synthesizable. Means the synthesis tool cannot interpret that code into a hardware. And the high level constructs that we use are loops. Like for during this modeling technique, the behavioral modeling technique, we use different loops. These are high level constructs. Okay, for, while, then we use delay, then repeat, case, function, task, if else, parameter, then different type of delay we use. Okay, so here it doesn't give any, as I said, it doesn't give any information how the gates will be implemented. So it is more like writing an algorithm in C. These constructs, the mentioned here, these constructs are very powerful. But designer should know RTL Verilog Infos hardware. That one, what I said, that whatever code that we write, it must be interpreted as the real hardware. Okay. And we are not implementing any kind of algorithm. So we are writing a code so that code will be interpreted as a real hardware. But this gate level modeling doesn't give means there is no guarantee that code will be interpreted or the behavioral modeling technique will be interpreted into a real hardware. Okay. Synthesis tool take complete behavioral model and synthesize it, and logic generated are not optimal. Okay. So if the synthesis tool synthesize the behavioral model, then it doesn't generate an optimal code. So it should be avoided. Writing this behavioral modeling should be avoided where there is an important consideration factors like area or speed. So if there is a factors like area and speed has to be considered, then we should avoid this writing behavioral modeling. So where do you use this behavioral modeling? Behavioral modelings are normally used during this verification, we can say verification, or we can say writing test bench. These are very, very helpful during test bench writing or verification, the RTL verification, we can say. Behavioral modeling is divided into two types. One is continuous. So what we do in continuous, here assignments of data to outputs are continuous. This is implemented using explicit assign statements or by assigning a value to a wire during its declaration. It uses Boolean logic and gate connections. For example, if I write the code like this, so whenever there is a changes in this side, there is changes in S, it will be updated at the same moment. It will be updated to the left side. So this assignment, this is a continuous assignment, and this one has to be for continuous assignment. This variable has to be declared as wire. Okay, where here I have declared as wire. This is what this paragraph is saying. Okay, so if I implement this code, always begin out equal to A and S bar. So whenever there is a changes in S, S bar will be updated, and whenever there is will be change in S bar, this out will be updated. Okay, so this is a continuous assignment. So this is also behavioral modeling technique, this one also, because always is there, this is a procedural block, we can say. Okay, so one is continuous and another one is procedural. Okay, so second one is procedural. Here data assignments are not carried out continuously. Here data assignments is continuous, because whenever there is a changes in right side, that will be updated at the same moment to the left side, and we are using this continuous assignment. Okay, so this is, but during procedural assignments, during these assignments, datas are not carried out continuously. Instead, it happens on specific events specified in sensitivity list. Means this in procedural statement, it is controlled by the sensitivity list. You will get to know when there will be always block, when I will be discussing about always block. Okay, so for example, in this code, raise out input S A, assign S bar equal to not of S. So this is my sensitivity list, A and S, always at the rate A S. So when there will be a changes in this sensitivity list A or S, instantly at that moment this will be evaluated. Okay, and this line will be executed. Okay, so this one, so when there is a changes in sensitivity list, this statement will be executed at the same moment. Okay, so this is my procedural. That one was continuous, this one is procedural. Okay, so it depends on the sensitivity list. This modeling is implemented using procedural blocks such as always or initial. So in this modeling this behavioral modeling technique, we have a concept called procedural, and where we use normally always. This is implemented using always and initial keyword. Okay, here output variable must be defined as range. For example, here output, I am assigning this part right side to this left part. So out should be inside the always, everything should be declared as range, means the left hand, the assignment part should be declared as range. So out should be here, out should be range. Okay, because they need range infers like a register, and register holds the data. Okay, so they need to keep hold of previous value until new assignment occurs after any changes in sensitivity list. So unless until there is anything changes inside this sensitivity list, this data, the previous data, has to be held by this output. So we need to store the data, we need to hold the data. So that is the reason why we are using here range out, because so that this out will store, or this out will hold the data unless until there is any changes in the sensitivity list. Okay, so this is how the behavioral modeling works. So we should avoid the behavioral modeling technique because it is not a synthesizable one, because in most of the cases, if we do not follow this RTL guidelines, then this won't be synthesizable. But mostly this gate level and data flow modeling technique, these are synthesizable. Okay, so we should avoid writing behavioral modeling, but these are very very useful construct at higher level, like writing test bench or writing verification code. So thank you so much for watching.